Hello, welcome to you all. Today I am going to discuss about design of Kennedy key. As I have earlier discussed in previous video, what is the Kennedy key? Kennedy key is the consist of two square key in a shaft for heavy duty application. Here I am considering different notation to design a Kennedy key. L is the length of the key, P is the force on a key in Newton, MT is the torque transmitted in a shaft, Newton mm, B is the width and height of the key, because we basically use square key in a design of Kennedy key. So in a square key we know that height and width are equal. Small d is the diameter of the shaft. Here I am considering one section, one end of the key section, in which the torque and power load is acting on the key. In this, suppose I am here assuming that the shaft is rotating clockwise, so the acting force on a key is this one, P, in the AD plane. So for equilibrium condition, the component which is connected to the shaft will react, and this reaction will act on this plane BC. So due to that, we will need to analyze what is the effect of this force P on this key. So as we know, and as we calculated earlier, for a square or flat key, torque transmitted in the shaft, suppose that torque transmitted value is MT and load value is P, perpendicular distance for the shaft is from center D by 2, so the torque will be P into D by 2. Because here in a Kennedy key we basically use two square key in a shaft, so the load will distributed in each of the shaft, so we need to divide the torque value by 2, so the final load with respect to torque relation will come out as like this. P is equal to MT divided by D. Small d is the diameter shaft, MT is the torque transmitted, P is the load acting on the key. So to design a Kennedy key, there is a two ways to design it on the basis of failure. First failure will be due to shear stress failure on a key. Shear stress will occur due to this force P in this section AC, in plane AC. The section will shear out like this. This is the free body diagram of that section. So the shear stress relation with respect to load into area, load and area, tau is equal to load upon resting area, area of plane AC. AC means this length AC along the length of key. So how we can calculate this length AC, which is resisting the shear stress, or which will fail when the shear stress will exceed the value of permissible. So for that, we know that the key has, square key has same width and height. It means B is equal to H. So here I am assuming this base and this is as a height B. So applying Pythagoras theorem, AC will come out as square root of B square plus B square, which is final resultant as a AC is equal to root 2 of B. And this area will be root 2 B into L, which is resisting area for shear. So tau is finally come out as a P divided by root 2 BL. Putting this equation A value of load in this condition, so we achieve tau is equal to MT divided by BDL root 2 for calculation of dimension or for checking of the stresses. Second way is to failure due to crushing stress. Applying crushing stress criteria, crushing stress in this component is equal to load upon resting area. Here the resting area will be minimum area which will crush in this triangle, which is resisting the load in a key, because this triangle ADC is inside the shaft and ABC is outside the shaft. So the we need to design a key which resists this load. So basically this section ABC, triangle ABC, will resist the load acting on the key. So we need to consider in this section minimum area which will resist the load P for crushing stress. So in this triangle, this BC is B and this AB is also B, because this key has a square type key. So to calculate the smallest section in AC hypotenuse, we draw from point B a perpendicular line, this hypotenuse, which will intersect in this point O. This OB is the smallest length which will fail due to crushing. To calculate OB, we take sine 45 in this triangle OCB or OBA. So with that we can calculate OB minimum value is equal to B by root 2. So we know that this crushing stress will occur throughout the key length. So multiply resisting area OB into L, which will come out as a resisting area B by root 2 into L. P by B root 2 L is the shear stress. This, putting the value of P from equation number 1, this equation, we can conclude that sigma C is equal to MT root 2 by BDL. From this equation and from shear stress equation, we can calculate dimension of the shaft, and we can check the stresses value or whether the component will save or not. So this is, I hope you like this video. If you have any doubt or any query related to this topic, so please comment below this video and please press the like button, please, and also subscribe my channel and press bell icon adjacent to subscription button to get further notification related to my channel videos which I am going to publish. In further videos I am going to solve few problems related to keys, design of key, design of knuckle joint, quarter joint, and different other topics. If you have any topic which you wanted to cover up in upcoming videos, please share with me, so I can help you to give a lecture on that topic. So thank you very much.